came to see Dr. Ludmilla because I was feeling very unwell.
One, two.
2 years ago, I came to see Dr. Ludmilla. A friend of mine brought me to see her because I'd been feeling unwell for so many years now. And I've been doing homeopathic remedies for over 2 years. They helped me. It wasn't just a part of homeopathy. I also took up yoga, changed my diet, was very careful about what I was eating, and took a general interest in my body and knowing how my body functions. So since now I've been taking homeopathic remedies for 2 years, I now feel a completely different person. All my friends tell me that I look really healthy, really clean, really fit and really well. For 2 years I've not taken any paracetamol, I've not been sick, I've not had any headaches or colds. I feel this is a confirmation of things, combining the fact that you actually feel good about yourself, you have a healthy lifestyle, you deal with your stress in a course of meditation or yoga, and in a whole that you feel wholly well for yourself.
stay still. Don't look at me. Look there, please. Hmm? Don't look at the camera, look there. Okay, what's your name, please?
My name is Liao Wenchen.
What did you do just now?
I'm going to have my Kung Fu class. Liao Wenchen, I from South China. I have been Dubai for teaching and teaching Kung Fu and Tai Chi 3 years. Now I'm working in Wapi City from Hollis Medical Center. It's okay.
Okay.
interested in more natural methods of healing, and I think I would much rather do that than look at antibiotics, allopathic type medicines. So I would always choose a more natural approach to begin with.
Have you tried homeopathy?
Yes, I have many times.
And what have your experiences been?
I've been very lucky that I haven't had any major problems. So the type of homeopathy that I've used has been mostly for ailments, perhaps digestive problems sometimes, colds, insect bites, lots of things like that, really.
And do you think it works better than...
Wait, the question
was, have you used homeopathic treatments? And then go on to say how whether you had a positive effect or not.
Okay, you're going to ask me that again?
Okay, recording.
Have you used homeopathic treatments before?
Yes, many times. Mostly for ailments, really. I use it in first aid situations with my family and myself. We've been lucky enough not to have anything major, but I've always chosen the homeopathic route to begin with, really.
And have you had better experiences, or have you had bad experiences on allopathy?
I haven't had bad experiences, but I've always tried to avoid antibiotics because I feel that it doesn't really treat the real problem, whereas I think that homeopathy actually treats the body and the person in a holistic way, which I feel is much more sensible, really. It makes sense to me to do that.
Why do you think an integrated approach using different methods of complementary healing is effective?
Well, I guess not every complementary type treatment suits everybody. So therefore, I think if you can use other treatments, eventually, you know, you're going to find something that actually suits you as a person. And I think homeopathy works very well with massage, yoga, which are also holistic type treatments and also beneficial to the person as a whole.
What makes...
I feel as if I'm not sure. I hope you're going to airbrush all this. I don't want.
Okay, recording.
What makes the holistic medical center different from other places?
Well, in my previous experience, I have been to other homeopaths before, but certainly with my experience with Dr. Ludmilla and the holistic healing center, is that it gives me more confidence because she is actually a medical doctor as well. And I find that, as I said, that gives much more confidence knowing that if for some reason the homeopathy is not appropriate, then she has the background to be able to deal with any problems that may arise.
What have your experiences with yoga been?
Well, I've with yoga, I feel that... yoga as long-term experience and also practice of yoga myself, I found that it really has... Sorry.
It's okay, don't worry.
I'm repeating myself. It's awful when you start to hear yourself say the same thing. Yoga works on a very different level to normal exercise, and in my experience and practice of yoga in the past and ongoing, I've noticed huge differences in the way people are physically, spiritually, and emotionally. People tend to be much calmer, it also works yoga. A lot of the postures actually work on the whole hormonal and endocrine system, which improves metabolism. Also, a lot of people have back problems, physical problems like that, and it can really help to allow them to become more supple, more body aware. And really, that's my experience. So it really does work. Again, I think it's important to look at lots of different things, because people are all different and all individual. And so working with maybe massage, as well as yoga, as well as homeopathy, I think all those things combined can really help to give a person optimum health. I think in my experience over the years, working with people and talking to people, friends, family, as well as patients and clients, I think that people have been given allopathic medicine for such a long time, and they go along to their GP or doctor and they find that, you know, 6 months down the line they're still actually ending up with the same antibiotics and nothing has changed. They just end up with different symptoms. And I think now people are moving away from that and looking at homeopathy and other holistic type treatments that can actually give them more
individually outlined a program.
Okay. Do you want me to look at iridology as well?
Yeah, that would be nice. So say, for example, you're telling, just as if you're telling a friend, you know, about the holistic medical center who's asking you how do you get good help out of these problems, what sort of advice would you give?
Okay.
You would tell them that, oh, if you go there, they'll do iridology, she'll use homeopathy, she'll outline diet for you, she'll send you to yoga classes, an individualized plan.
Yeah. First of all, I would say you need to have some sort of diagnosis of what the problem is. And certainly with the Holistic Health Centre, there are facilities there with treatments like iridology, colon hydrotherapy, all those sort of things that can actually help to diagnose what your problem may be. That's half the battle, I think. Once you know what the difficulties are, then the treatment is available to you. And it will be a safe and effective treatment, I'm sure.
So what kind of plan do you think the doctor would implement?
Well, I think from my personal experience, Dr. Miller would probably give you an iridology session to start with. She would also look at your past health history, and from that you'd get a wider picture of your health, and from that information she would then advise on different homeopathic remedies or other treatments that they offer in the centre, so that you can actually work towards becoming well again.
Thank you.
opportunity.
And I just came for 2 years.
Oh no.
Only.
For 2 years.
We're here.
For 2 years.
So I
want
to ask
only, and I've been here 14.
Really?
Mm.
And you like it?
Yeah, like
it grows on you.
You start to feel like you can't live anywhere else.
Yeah.
And
so
you complain.
You go back and you complain about this and that. And you start.
Somebody was telling us that you have no, from California, you have no idea. Just to let your children go out and play and not know and not feel that there's any danger is something that you don't even understand how great that privilege is, you know.
Absolutely.
To live in peace and
No, it's very easy going, it's everything's so close. Everything is
major traffic jams.
Not yet. No, everything is
seeing her 8 months ago, and minor problems, allergies, stomach aches, problems with my cycle, and she just told me how everything is connected. You can't go and treat one symptom, your allergies, and take all these antihistamines and then you're fine. Something else suffers. And also how all these are connected, all the problems. So she sees the whole person, one body, one organism.
Yeah, she takes her time. She goes.
Takes her time. Also, your character as well.
Right.
She studies the character and what is appropriate for you. And I've seen really a major result. More in harmony with my body. Of course, I studied yoga as well, which helps a lot. And with my daughter, I have seen tremendous change as well, because even in her attitude, she's very stubborn and not willing and quite fussy and not easy to manage. And she's more she's cooperating more, and she's happier, and she doesn't. Really amazing, especially with her. I've seen a difference within a month.
Yeah, it is a quick result.
Really,
I
took her for tummy aches and problems in digestion.
Acupuncture.
Oh yeah,
I was hospitalized for a big operation.
Yeah.
Had the side effect of what it was until I started the acupuncture.
sense emotionally, and I, you know, you could tell, you know, even though it might be subtle differences, but.
Yoga.
Thank you.
basically, we build up a lot of chemicals in our body from antibiotics and any other medicine. So it's really, you know, you basically build up resistance to illnesses. You know, if a child is cough, it's so easy for the doctors just to say, well, I'm going to give him antibiotics. And we used to do this every 3 or 4 weeks.
And of course, the
believe it or not.
Yes, and the side effects, of course,
yes.
are not really fully appreciated or understood, are they? I think one of the interesting things about the homeopathic medical industry, if you like, is that one tends to think that homeopathic medicines work perhaps too slowly. So a lot of people immediately feel, oh, I want a quick cure, because everybody's under lots of pressure at their work or running their families. So they immediately think, well, of course, a doctor is going to work more quickly, because that's how we've been brought up, how we're used to it. And for me, the real turning point, the absolute belief in all this, came when Frederick was sick, I think shortly after he had his glandular fever, and he had a terrible viral infection, stomach virus, with a very high temperature. And Dr. Ludmilla came immediately. I think his temperature was running at 39.
40.
And had been 39-40 for, I think, about 36 hours, 24 to 36 hours. Dr. Ludmilla came, I remember, one evening, 8 o'clock, and administered a strong liquid, I don't know what it was, of homeopathic medicine. And she said, now, you're going to, your son's going to have this, and his temperature's going to go down, and it's not going to go back up again. And of course, this is the great test for any sort of agnostic, because normally you would give a child Tixilix or Calpol, and the temperature would go down, but then later on it would go back up again. But here, within 50 minutes, so by 10 to 9 in the evening, Frederick's temperature went down, and that was it, and it never went up again. And it was a bit like, you know, reading about one of those miracles, something very, very unusual. I mean, I'm sure it is very usual, but, you know, for me, it was an enormous eye-opener.
Do you think a lot of people are sceptical?
I think it's all to do with habit, the way we're brought up.
And not enough information there.
You know, but I think, on the other hand, I think scepticism is definitely giving way to trust, you know, and belief. I mean, I've got two daughters in London who are 18 and 16. You know, they take belladonna and pulsatilla and drink herbal teas. I mean, not instead of coffee, but, you know, it's also a move in that direction. So trying to avoid, you know, I don't know, what do we call it, traditional, orthodox, allopathic medicine, because of the side effects, you know, and one sort of read about what inoculations can do to babies, to the heart tissues, for instance. You know.
And what kind of allergies they can create later on in life. Having said that, of course, this is an issue which is a great debate still between doctors themselves and parents. I think that the two can work side by side together. And with Dr. Ludmilla and her husband, actually, the great reassurance is that they are doctors. Of medicine, general practitioners, hospital doctors who turned to homeopathic treatment. So therefore they are aware of both possibilities.
The last question is, why do you need an integrated approach for medicine if you do think that medicine, choosing different types of complementary modalistic healing methods together?
Well, first of all, today I would first start with homeopathic medicine. naturally, you know, I go back to what you call today the traditional medication. I'm not against it. It's just that I don't want to see my son take any more antibiotics. And if it's not necessary, why should I give him chemically induced harmful medicine?